And hello everyone, this is it, the last group stage match of TMM Team Cup 2019. The decisive match for the qualification, of course, because have a look at the group B. So Venture has a 3-2 ratio, and yeah, two losses is really the maximum you can afford, as you can see, because yeah, there's only one more match and you need to secure the top 8 to go to playoffs. So we will have ties at a 4-2 ratio. So even with a win, Venture is not guaranteed to qualify. But if they lose tonight, they are obviously out of the tournament. That's for sure. And THC Blue needs to win in order to be completely safe. Since if they lose tonight, they have the chance of going out due to the ties. So here is the situation. So yeah, quite an important match, especially since Venture didn't have a very good seed falling on THC Blue, which is a very, very strong team. So yeah, let's take a look maybe first at the rules. So it will be best of three maps, 4v4 until 7 without tennis mode. And yeah, as it's Swiss system, you face a team with the same points as you, or almost the same point as you, if it's an odd number of teams that have the same numbers of points as you. So yeah, 6 matches, and this is the 6th match of the cup. So yeah, let's take a look if it's not starting. No, it's not. We have still a bit of time. So yeah, we have the lineup for Venture with Horny, Dutchy, Scary, Matic, Sulja, Beats, Wagenche, Zykos, Kugako, Kimi, Dan, and Shumi. So yeah, 2 losses against Runtime and MNM. Two very good teams, of course. So maybe not the best luck at the seeding, but that's how Swiss system works. I mean, it has always been quite matchup reliant, I would say. So yeah, and here is THC Blue. THC Blue, who got actually a very bad qualification, qualifying only 19th. So yeah, the qualification was held on a TTC format, so I guess they kind of choked it, since of course you have to go the furthest without going out as a TTC. So yeah, maybe they fucked up this one, because they performed really good this cup, and they have actually a 4-1 ratio. I messed up my graphic, and because THC Blue won against Neurotech, their only loss was against UB Team. So yeah, quite an impressive route so far for THC Blue. So it would be, of course, a very tough opponent, with, of course, very good players like Dexter, Shorty, Rombo, Toddy, Deska, Mopel. Yeah, all of those players are very, very good. Very, very good. So I guess we have 2 more warm-ups. Let's go in-game. I think I've explained it all. I think I've explained the whole situation. And you can see that I have a new score overlay. I hope you like it. Should be a bit easier to use than the previous one I had. So seems like the first map will be TMM Money by Deska. WR is by Wagenche from Venture, actually, with a 42.96. Maybe let's take a look at the other Dedi Mania. We can see Masix Dedi 4, Dutchy Dedi 11, Soulja Dedi 14, Jaka Dedi 16. I don't see any player from THC. Oh, there we are. Dan Dedi 24 and Piranha Dedi 29, which is the only THC player in the Dedi. And that's it. So maybe they train offline, or maybe their PBs aren't that good. I don't know. I guess time will tell. And Deska with a beautiful fox skin, of course. And yeah, Deska actually playing on his own map. So yeah, let's see if he will perform good on his own map. This is, of course, not guaranteed. You can suck on your own map. Happens quite often, actually. But yeah, I guess it depends on the player. Some players are very good on their own maps, meanwhile some others aren't. And it seems like we are starting now, so good luck, have fun. This is it. Venture need to win in order to stay alive in this cup, and preferably with a good margin. Otherwise, they can be fucked with the ties at the end of this play day. So let's follow Deska, and seems like it's a very good start for the Venture players, because only Eddie is at the front for THE, like a lot of blue players. So yeah, not the best start for Team THE. So far it's even an ace for... it's even an ace for Venture. I don't know why the music is shutting off. But yeah, Vagenche quite far in front of Dutchie, Solja, and then all the THE team. So yeah, sounds very good for Venture, very good end by Deska, but that won't change anything. And yeah, very good time by Vagenche, only 3/10 away from his own WR, so the first blood will be for Venture. 1-0 on the first map. So yeah, of course winning by a big margin will be important, since in case of ties in the group stage standings, the goal average will matter to decide who will be in front of who. So yeah, quite a better start here for THE compared to the previous round. I see a lot of red players at the front. Oh, but Eddie crashed for THE. Oh, and Dan as well for Venture. Quite a undecided round so far. I guess it's for THE since Piranha, and I don't have any interesting hotkeys, but Piranha will take it. I guess it will be a round. Yes, it will be a round for THE. So yeah, THE tying up the score at 1 point apiece. Let's check that everything is working. It is. Let's follow Dutchy, who recently reached the grand final of Gaming Winterfest, getting third place at Gaming Winterfest. Now he's back to TMM with his teammates, and once again a pretty good start by the Venture players. Only Piranha is at the front, which wouldn't be enough for them to secure the round. Quite a... Eddie has no speed at all, so he will get overtaken by Dan. So far it's a blue round for sure. Yes, it will, despite Piranha winning the round, it will be a round for Venture. Good time by Piranha, 43-29. Very, very good times. Quite close rounds, actually. But yeah, Venture having a wide point lead once again. So, oh, but someone from THE crashed. I guess it was Piranha, and Dutchie stumbles a bit, but he doesn't lose too much actually. No one crashed into the chicane. I saw someone crashing there, but I couldn't see who it was, since both teams are using blue skins, which makes it very confusing. Oh, Vagenche going very close to the wall, Dan as well, but they're holding it still. Quite a good start of a round for Team Venture, with a lot of players at the front, only Deska and Eddie keeping up with them. So it should be a blue round again. Yeah, Deska having no speed at all. It will even be an ace! No, it won't! Eddie will prevent the ace from happening. But yeah, oh, very, very good time by Vagenche, 43-25. So yeah, now they have a 2-point lead for Team Venture, which is, of course, a very good thing. So yeah, Venture looks looks well prepared on this map, a bit more than THE. But of course there is still a long way to go into this match. And Piranha crashed, and also Shorty, so, and Deska is pretty far behind, so looks pretty bad for THE right now. It might even be an ace for Venture at this point. But right now it's again Eddie preventing the ace. Let's follow Eddie to see if he prevents the ace. Oh, AD will even come back to second place, but that won't be enough. That won't be enough despite doing a 43-27 and Vagenche. Vagenche going bomb, 43-23, winning another round. Look at the individual scores at the top left of the screen. You can see that Vagenche is very, very strong, 35 points already. He's carrying his team, and his teammates are following actually. Top 3 in the standings are Venture players. So yes, 3-1 now for Team Venture, looking very good on this map. 4-1 even. Yes, it's 4-1. So looking very good for Venture on this map. Of course, they need also a good score difference. That would help them a lot. And Soulja Vagenche again, top 2 should be a blue point once again. Piranha though has super 6 speed, Piranha coming back even to second place maybe. Oh, and Vagenche stumbles, but Dan comes back. Oh, it will still be a round for Venture, but... Oh, it was close because Vagenche got a very bad end. Vagenche got a very bad end and... luckily, Dan got the... Dan got very good speed at the end, so... That secures another round for Team Venture, going 5-1, so pretty good lead. Yeah, I agree that the car skin looks very similar. Maybe THE should have played with the THE orange or the THE pink skin. Oh, Dan crashed, but Eddie as well. So it's a 3 versus 3 situation now. Oh, but Piranha crashed and it was in the lead. That's of course very good for Team Venture. Vag and Dutchie top 1 and 2. But Shorty and Deska coming back. Shorty with a super weird skin. Second place skin actually, but yeah, he will take second with his second place skin in this round. But that won't be enough because it will be a round for Venture. Soulja taking first, Dutchie third, Vagenche fifth, and Dan seventh. So it would be the first map point of the match for Team Venture, 6.1. It's the perfect way to start a match, to be honest. Everything is going as planned, and someone got a slowdown at the start, but I couldn't see who. I think it was someone from Venture, but I'm not sure about that. Piranha once again in the lead, definitely the fastest THE guy, even though he hasn't scored that many points. Maybe not consistent enough. But yeah, Dan and Dutchie top 1 and 2, so that should be it. That should be it with this map, because I see Soulja is not too far behind. Piranha will need to get first, and I see that Dutchie crashed, but Piranha as well, so that should be it. That should be it, yeah, Dan and Soulja top 1 and 2, that should be it. Yes, it will. The first map will go to Team Venture. Very, very strong first map for Team Venture. They were way ahead of their opponent. Let's see if the score of my keyboard shortcut worked. Oh, yes, it did. That score overlay is amazing. So yeah, Venture won the first map. Venture won the first map, so... Oh yeah, I forgot to explain the pick and mam system, so... As Venture won the first map, they have the right to ban a map, and then Trackmania Heroes Europe will pick a map, which will be the second map played, and the total pool is 6 maps. And yeah, the first map that was played is always the latest map released. So you know in advance which map is played first. So Horny banned Allure and Mopple picked Poco Loco. So we will play Poco Loco as second map. Meanwhile, Allure won't be played tonight. If you want to see that map, you will need to watch another match. So yeah, that was the Nevermind map. And yeah, we... oh, the pool is 5. Okay, my bad. Yeah, the pool is 5, so after second map, the winning team will ban a map and you will have only one map remaining in the pool. Which will be of course the third map played. So yeah, we will play the Poco Loco by Buzzy. pretty unusual map, I would say. At least it does look very unusual. Doesn't look like a bad map though. But I know this map got a bit of controversy. Due to the unusual side of it. So yeah, it's very very fast paced map. Very little room for error. You lose quite a lot of time pretty easily. So should be an interesting one. It's not a map for chokers at all, especially since the end, the ending as well is pretty difficult. Yeah, this jump, you can easily mess it up. Ah, okay. Okay, Kikam, thanks for clarifying this up. Seems like we'll have three warm-ups. And then we will go live again. So maybe let's take a look at the Daily Mania. So I think it's Katic who has WR. I think that player is Katic. With 41-71. You can see Jaka DD5. Dan DD16, Zykos DD17, Dexter DD18, but of course Dexter is not playing due to Trackmania Groundling happening right now. So Dexter is playing Trackmania Groundling instead of this match. Kimi DD21, Dutchie DD23, Moppel DD24, and Eddie DD27, and that's it for the players in this match. So I don't know, I think it's two more warm-ups. Before the match starting again. But yeah, we should see quite a lot of mistakes on this map. Because you have to risk it quite a lot. Very speedy. If you save it, you really lose a lot of time. And due to the map being pretty short, you can't really afford it. And yeah, you can miss the finish like Eddie did. Very easy mistake to do. So yeah, one more warm up. And then we're starting again. Let's see if we can guess the lineup already. I guess for Venture it will be Dan, Zykos, Dutchie, Kimi. And for THC it should be Eddie, Moppel, Piranha and Deska. So yeah, Moppel didn't play first map I believe. And Zykos didn't play first map as well. So two new players coming up on the field. Good luck, have fun. Venture can already close it out, but of course all three maps will be played and score difference will matter a lot for the qualification. So yeah, even if Venture wins this map, the match will be far from over. Yeah, we are starting. I guess we are spectating Eddie. Yes, we are. Let's follow Eddie for Trackmania Heroes Europe Blue. And yeah, Venture and THE used to be sister teams when the Venture lineups were still in MIMO, but yeah, the team kinda, the both teams kinda divorced from each other, so there's kind of a rivalry between between the two teams. So this makes the match even more spicy. But yes, Zykos in first place, looking pretty good, even though Deska has good feet, but Deska crashed, so it should be a blue round. Yes, it will, unless... Oh, but then she crashed the end, and Zykos! Zykos! But Venture got top 2, so I don't know, but Zykos won't finish. Ah, I don't know. But I think someone from THE... Will Zykos finish? No, he won't. Oh! what was that? Oh, it's still a round for Venture because only 3 players from each team finished the round. I was afraid that it would be a tie, but it would have been a tie if the 4th players from THG would have finished. I think so. So yeah, 1-0 for Venture on this map, and quite a meme round already. So yeah, Mopper right now in first place. Oh, but Deska with a lot of speed. Eddie coming up to first, Mopper in second. Kimi crashed, or at least got a landing bug, rather. But at least he's out of this round. Oh, Deska landing on the Rammstein, but doesn't get punished for it. Zykos back to first in front of two THG players. Zykos will need to take first. Oh, I guess he will. Yes, Zykos will take first, and someone from THG crashed. It was Piranha, I believe. So it will be a blue round in the end. Oh, that... The rounds will be so undecided on this map until the very end. That will be very spicy, and Venture already with a 2 points lead. 2-0. Let's follow Deska. Deska without too much of a good start, but it's still pretty packed. The beginning of the map is pretty easy. It's starting from here that it becomes very tricky, and you can see already, I think it's Kimi who crashed for Venture, so one player is down, but Zykos back to first. Zykos going booms on this map, but it's 3 THG players behind him, so it won't be enough even if he wins the round. No one will... Yes! Mopper will miss the end! I think it's a blue round! I think it is! No, it's a tie! Oh my god, it's a tie because of Mopper's crash! Again, THG blue messing up in the end, despite having the round quite in the bag. Like at the 2/3 of the maps, they look better than Venture, but they do late mistakes that cost them 2 points already. Oh, someone from Venture crashed. I don't know who it was. I think it was Dan. Yes, it was Dan, but Mopple crashed. No, not Mopple. It was Piranha. Oh, sorry for that. But yeah, Zykos in first. But once again, Deska and Eddie right behind him. I guess it's a blue round still, especially since Deska is overtaken by... Oh, but Zykos fell down in the end. I think it's a... Yes, it's a red point for sure. Yes, it will be a point for THG blue due to Zykos' late mistake. Oh, those rounds are crazy, man. So yeah, THG blue will reduce the score 2-1, but yeah, what an intense map, what an action-packed map. Let's follow Deska, and I see a crash already. I think it was I don't know who it was. Maybe Dutchy. Oh, but Deska crashed. No, it wasn't Dutchy. So it should have been someone from THG. So it looks indeed very good for Venture. They have top 3 right now. Zykos, Dan and Kimi, they have a pretty big lead, should be a blue point until they mess up the end. Zykos going very close to the wall, Mopel coming back at the end, but shouldn't matter. Yes, it won't. It won't matter. And yes, indeed, beautiful fox skin. As I mentioned it earlier. Yes, Deska is pretty much the only player you can recognize, since everyone else has a blue skin. So yeah, Venture is extending their lead. They have now a 2-point lead. Zykos once again in the lead, and Eddie crashed! Eddie's out, not what THG needs. Ah, looks very good for Venture once again. Unless they mess up Dutch. Ooh, Dan going very close to the edge. But he kept it on track, only Mopple at the front for THG, so it should be an easy blue point. But yes, they can still mess up the end, of course. I hope they won't. No, they won't. They managed to save it. Oh, I think Dutch team is the finish, but it won't matter. Yeah. Dutch actually missed the finish, but that doesn't matter. And you can see that, yeah, Zykos is top fragging as expected. And Eddie also is going pretty good carrying his team. But yeah, 3-point lead now for Venture, 4-1. Looking pretty good on this match. They look to have the upper hand. Even though it's closer on this map than it was on the first one. But yeah, Zykos once again in the lead, but he went very wide there and he had to release. So that allows 3 THC players at the front, so it looks very good for THC now. Top 3 for THC with Eddie, Moppel and Deska. Oh, but Deska crashed! Deska crashed and he had to go the safe way. I can't spec everyone else. What's going on? Let's follow Kimi. Still top 2 for THC. Will they mess up the ending? No, they won't. But it's 3 THC play, 3 Venture players behind them, so I think it's THC run still. Yes, it is a THC run still. And very good time by Eddie, 41.94. Very, very good good run. And yes, it's played till 7. Oh, Deska crashed! Could recognize the beautiful Fox skin and Piranha as well, so not looking very good for THC. Danzo lost a bit of ground. Dutchie as well. So Mopal and Eddie can still do something there. My hotkeys are pretty shit, so let's follow Eddie. But yeah, top 2 for Zykos and Kimi, even top 3 even. So if they don't mess up the ending, Dutchie and Eddie both crashed! But I think it's still blue points because, yeah, Mopper missed the end as well. And Zykos, Kimi, and Dan kept it on track. Very, very good times by Zykos and Kimi going sub 41. So, yeah, 5-2 now for Venture, extending the lead once again. Oh, Kimi with a very poor start. He went very wide. But he managed to come back on the. But he crashed! Kimi's out of this round, or at least he lost some ground. Oh, Dutchie, I thought Dutchie would crash there, but yeah, good good start from Zykos and from Dan, Deska keeping up with them. But it seems like Venture has a bit of the upper hand, but it's still very, very close. Let's follow Eddie. So yeah, Zykos looks to take the round, but behind him is very undecided. Oh, it's 3 THC players behind him. I think it's a tie. I think it's a tie. Should be a tie. Oh no, it's a red point. My bad. I'm very bad at calling whom round it is. So THC reducing the scores, they're staying alive in this match. But yeah, someone flipped. Someone from THC flipped. I think it is Moppel. Yes, it's Moppel who flipped. I don't know if he will be able to finish. But oh, Kimi crashed, but it still look like a good run for a Venture, even though Eddie's coming back. Eddie going doing a very, very good job for his team. Second in the standings behind Zykos. But yeah, right now Eddie is quite alone for his team, so it should be a blue point once again. Yes, it will. No one will miss the finish this time. So it would be a match point for Venture. Match point already. 6-3. But of course, winning the match might not be enough, so yeah. Just to be safe, they would need to win the third map as well. To secure a good score difference. Oh, Kimi crashed again! Kimi did a very good match so far, but he crashed the last 2 rounds, or even 3 rounds, and Moppel crashed as well. And Eddie is pretty far behind, so Venture might just take it there. They have a top 2 right now, with Zykos and Dan. The Sky is quite close, but Zykos will crash! Zykos will crash and The Sky will take the round! Oh, but I don't think that will matter. I don't know. I think it's... yeah, it's Blue Point. Yeah, because of Dan getting second place. Oh, what a close call with Zykos' mistake. But luckily, he was able to stay in front of the bottom two THC players. Otherwise, that would have been a red point. Let me update the score. So, yeah. Venture won the match, but of course the match is not over. We will have to play a third map for score difference. THC picked Solaris, so we will play Solaris. It should be the last map of the evening. So yeah, score difference will matter. According to my calculation, we will have like 6 teams tied at a 4-2 ratio, and it will go until 10th place, so yes. The tie will decide... the last map will decide... I don't know what I was saying. I got lost. Yeah, I meant the score difference of course will matter. Some teams will be eliminated due to score difference. Venture can of course be one of them. But since they lost the match, THC Blue is also a team that need to have a good score difference. Because Venture and THC Blue will be tied in the standings. So they both need to secure a good score difference. So yeah, of course this map will be very important. So we are waiting for Vagancher to connect. Here he is. Thus, we'll have 3 warm-ups after this one. I thought my game would I thought my game crashed for a sec. And thank you for the host, John. It was 15 minutes ago, but I only see it now. So yeah, we have 3 more warm-ups. I think it was 7-3. Yes, it was 7-3. I wasn't sure if it was 7-3 or 7-4, but yeah, it was 7-3. So we are seeing some new players warming up with Horny, the captain, and Scary and Skugacho. All 3 players didn't play yet in this match. I guess we have already an idea of the lineups. It will be Skugacho, Horny, Scary and Vagancher. Vagancher who played first map. So 3 new players for Venture on this last map. And for THC Blue, it will be Shorty, Eddie, Mopple and Piranha. I think Shorty didn't play yet. So Shorty is the only new player for THC. So yeah, from the last match I casted, which was against Redemption Gaming, Venture struggled a lot on this map. They actually almost lost it. So yeah, maybe they trained it more since. I think they didn't train much back then, so they had 2 more weeks to train that, so they should be ready now. At least I hope so. So yeah, this map doesn't look very hard, but seems like you can risk it quite a lot, which means of course the mistake is easy to happen. You can, yeah, you see way more mistakes than you could expect on this map. So yeah, this map is made by Zengo, and WR is by PK Dickens in 4703, and Vagancher did it too. Mobile is 4th, Skugako in 11th, Scary 12th, Eddie 15th, and that's it for the players playing in this match, because of course only top 30 matters in the Daddy Manias. Yeah, let me drink my water. There we go. Let's just ensure that my score overlay. I didn't fuck up the shortcuts. I did not. And we are starting. To be Vagenshe, Horny, Skugako, and Scary against Mopple, Shorty, Piranha, Eddie. Final map, Venture. Already won the match, but of course the score difference will matter for both teams as they will be tied in the standings. And yeah, not everyone will make it with this ratio, so both teams need to storm the other one, but someone from THC crashed. I can't see who it was. My brain is way too slow for that. But it was someone from THC, that's for sure. Shorty is back with his second place skin. But yeah, Mopple right now in first. Looks pretty good for THC if they secure top 2. Yes, right now it is a red point. So if they keep it up, they will score the first point of this. But Teddy crashed! Oh, will that matter though? I don't know. I'm not too sure about it. No, it won't. It will still be a red point. So the first blood will go to THC on this third map. So yeah, second round on this map. Scary with a very good start. But of course the field is pretty packed right now. Oh, surely going super close to the wall, but he saved it. Yeah, what a close round so far. Mopper in first, but Scary is challenging him, even Horny, but Horny will have not so much speed. Out of that turn, Skugako is coming back as well. Mopper still in first with a pretty good lead now, but behind him it's only blue players. So should be blue point, but the last turn will decide it. If Eddie can come back, he can save the round to his team. Oh, Eddie going super wide. He risked it a lot, but it will be four blue players behind Mopper. What a close round! Six players in 2/10. Oh my god. So yeah, Venture will tie up the score at 1 point apiece. That map looks very, very close. We might see a 7-6 score, whoever takes it. Oh, but someone completely failed it. It was someone from THC for sure, because I see four blue players. But yeah, I don't know who it was. So yeah, it looks pretty good for Venture, I would say so far. But of course, the field is still pretty packed and surely hit the checkpoint. But luckily, he didn't lose too much time. But it's top 3 for Venture right now. Only Mopple is keeping up. Only challenging Venture for first. But Skugako with 6 speed. So it should be a blue point quite easily. Skugako going very wide, but oh, and Mopple hits the finish, but doesn't matter. Top 3 for Venture. Venture will take the lead in this map. Venture will take the lead in this final map. Of course, Venture so far have secured a pretty good score difference, I would say, because they lost quite a close match against M&M. So far they won 7-1, 7-3, which is of course a very good margin. They won with good margins also against Redemption Gaming and against Zero, and someone from Venture crashed. I think it was Scary. So yeah, I guess Venture has so far a pretty good difference, but of course they need to keep it up in order to be safe. I don't know how good is THC's score difference though. I have no clue actually. But yeah, Venture though had a pretty harsh loss against against Runtime, which will harm them a bit. And right now it looks to be a red point with Mopel in first and Shorty and Eddie behind him. Yes, it will. Pretty convincing round for THE Blue, tying up the score. Yeah, that map might be super close. So yeah, Mopel right now is top fragging with 4 venture players behind him, and yet the score is tight, so yeah, that's how much work Mopel has put in for his team. Mopel going very very strong on this map. And yeah, Piranha now taking the lead. But the field is very very packed, but I see a lot of red players. Looks pretty good for THE. Oh, and Horny flipped, so it looks even better for THE. I guess it's definitely a THE round now. Only Vagenshi at the top. So yeah, Vag won't even take first. So yeah, it's definitely a THE round. And I don't know why the music is shutting down sometimes. That's very annoying. The in-game music. I don't know why. So yeah, THE taking the lead in this map. Three points to two. So yeah, I guess this map will go either way at a 7-6 score, I'm pretty sure. But very good start by the Venture team actually. They have the top 4 right now. But not anymore because of Eddie coming back. But Eddie is the only one keeping up with the Venture players. But I see someone who stumbled a bit. I guess it was Horny? No, it wasn't Horny. I don't know who it was. But yeah, it won't matter that much. It was Vag. But yeah, it will still be a round for Venture. Pretty convincing round for Venture. With Kerry and Horny going into the 47.3. Which is only 3/10 away from WR, so that's obviously a very good consistency. A very good time to do in a match. So yeah, the score is tied again. 3 points apiece, and of course there is no tennis mode in group stage. No tennis mode in group stage. So yeah, pretty close round once again. Eddie in the lead, but a lot of players behind, and his teammates aren't too far neither, so yeah, this round can still go either way. It looks a bit better for THE though, with Eddie and Mopel at the top. Yeah, it looks like a red point, but yeah, the last turn will decide it, of course. Oh, and someone from THE crossed, so that might change things, and Skugako and Horny back to second and third. That might be a blue point, I don't know, I have no clue. I have no clue which round it is, and I think the last guy from... Yeah, surely he managed to finish. I have no clue which round it is. Is it... It's a blue point! THE fucked up the round at the end, so... So Venture is back in the lead. Venture is back in the lead on this map, 4 points to 3. So yeah, let's follow Scary for Venture, the Austrian player. Oh, Eddie crashed, not what THE need, and Piranha has very low speed. Mopel going super tight, but it looks very good for the blue team. Scary landing on the Rammstein, but he won't get punished for it. Almost top 3 for Venture, but Mopel crashed. That's definitely a blue point. Since Venture have top 3, yes it will. So yeah, Venture extending their lead. Only 2 points away from winning the map. Which would be of course perfect for the score difference. This is by far the closest map though. Venture played very, very well on the first two maps. It's a bit closer in this one. They could, if they could manage to take those next two rounds, that would be a very, very, very good result. And someone from THG crashed, I think it was... No, it wasn't Shorty. But it was someone from THG, that's for sure. I think it was Eddie. So yeah, top 2 right now for Venture, so it should be another outbreak of Varney going super, super wide, he had to save it. And yeah, THG can still take it with Mopel and Piranha gets a good end, which they will do, but Skugako will come back. I think it's Blue Point. And very good time by Vagenshi, 47.26. I think it's a Blue Point. But I don't know. Yes, it is a Blue Point, so it will. It is match point, map point, I mean, for Venture. 1 point away from winning this map, 7-3, which would be a very, very good result considering how close this map was. That would be a very, very generous score for Venture on this map. And that would be pretty much almost the perfect job if they managed to win a 7-1, 7-3, 7-3. But of course, oh, but Eddie will fly out the map! Eddie won't finish this round! Only 3 players for THG, that won't help him, and Vagenshi is so far in the lead, that should be it! That should be it, and Scary is even back to second place with very good speed out of the second to last turn. So it will be top 2 for Venture and only 3 players for THG, so that will be it. GG, very, 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 very strong performance for... from Venture taking home the match 7-1, 7-3, 7-3 against a very, very tough opponent. Yeah, that could have been way closer, especially since THG played pretty good. THG was trained with a good lineup. So yeah, that's a very, very good job for Venture. I don't know if they really qualify, because of course it will depend on the ties. But I guess tonight they did what they had to do. If Venture has to be eliminated, that won't be tonight's performance that caused it. That's for sure. That would have been the very, very harsh loss against Runtime, I guess. So yeah. Let's just hope now. We just need to look at the other matches and to use our calculators to see if Venture should make it. But I'm pretty confident, especially since they won by a big margin. I guess it should be fine. It should, but yeah, we can't be sure. We can't be sure about that. So yeah, that's it for me. I won't be here next week, unfortunately, for the first playoff match. It will be a double elimination playoffs. And even if Venture doesn't make it, there is a lower bracket, which I guess Venture would play. And if they don't, I would then stream other teams. But I guess they would. They would play it. So yeah, I won't be here next week, so... see ya in 2 weeks for the second playoff match against whoever it will be. So yeah, thank you for watching, thank you for the new followers, thank you for the hosts. We had several hosts tonight. So yeah, thank you for the support, and I hope to see you next time. See ya!